Yeah, a mix and a balance of kind of younger guys, veteran guys, new school mindset, maybe some more traditional old school. I think it's a great balance. We took our time. We wanted to get it right. And at the end, I think we came up with some really good names and really good fits for the staff. So I'm really excited and probably put more work into the staff, you know, for a month period than maybe in the past. So there are guys, some holdovers that have the continuity and the resources of knowing our guys. We have some new guys. I just feel like it's a really good staff, and I think we took a lot of time to put it together.
And what can you tell us about the role Brian Price is going to play specifically, and what does he bring in that capacity, and what can he bring to the staff?
Yeah, he brings a lot of baseball knowledge, a lot of years. You know, he's been a manager, he's been a pitching coach, he's been a special assistant. He's done it all. He's been on my staffs before. And what I think, you know, his role will be an advisor. He'll be there for the better part of all of spring training. And then during parts of the season, he'll kind of come and go, I think, which works really well, which gives a little perspective from, you know, for the staff, for a guy that's not there each and every day and kind of sees what has transpired, you know, in the time that he hasn't been with the team.
Hey, I was wondering what you thought was improved about this staff. This is quite a bit of turnover year to year.
Yeah, I mean, I think what Bob said, I think we're excited about the group. I mean, I think we have, you know, there's some, you know, I think, again, it's a blend of you know, some experience, some younger staff members that are anxious to get to the big league level for the first time. You know, I think probably the biggest thing at the end of the day that we're excited about is we've just got a lot of knowledge and expertise and content. So, you know, I think the other thing I think, like, you know, that in talking to Bob and really, you know, trying to put the staff together, having some crossover in terms of, you know, a couple different people in each area. So whether it's in the infield, whether it's on the pitching side, whether it's on the hitting side. You know, we have, you know, a few different staff members that are going to be able to help out in those different spots. That was by design, something that Bob talked about a lot. So I think, you know, having some continuity, having a lot of expertise, and then having, you know, a couple different people in each area that can take some ownership. I think those things are all very attractive to us with the staff.
From your perspective, what is it that a coaching staff should do the best? Because you mentioned experience and knowledge. You had a lot of experience and knowledge. This is a little bit more of a mix. What is it that this group brings that you're excited about? How will they make your players better?
Yeah, I mean, I think you know, I think, again, like setting a tone every single day. You know, I think that's part of it. I think definitely being able to lend some, you know, some expertise and being able to help guys through some different moments, or take a talented group and see them, you know, accentuate their skill set to where it's performance on the field. And you're just looking for a group that can achieve. So I think the coaching staff sets the tone, and then, you know, also they're able to give some, you know, whether it's pointers, individual, you know, technique, questions, thoughts, they can help them on that front, or help the talented roster go out and perform and achieve and, you know, feel good with the group that we put together.
Hey, Bob, I know that Francisco Cervelli, by
those who covered him, as has been described as the most interesting man in baseball. Before the lockout hit and you were unable to talk to players, how much feedback did you get from guys who played with him, including a current pitcher on your staff?
Yeah, I got a lot of feedback even before he was announced. So, I mean, when he was rumored to be potentially coming onto our staff, I got calls from all over the game about, you know, how energetic he is, about how knowledgeable he is, about how all in he is on every team that he's been and been with, and a clubhouse leader and so forth and so on. So to have that, you know, just coming off the field, the guys have played against this guy before, just a lot of knowledge and experience for a guy that might not be experienced coaching, but it's experienced in the game of baseball. And, you know, it came from all over. So we're really excited about him having. I just love listening to him talk. He's so passionate about what he's talking about. Obviously understands the catching dynamic. We'll have some real competition for that spot. And he's got some knowledge of these guys as well. So just brings a ton to the staff in an area that we feel like we need You know, a guy that understands the position, has just come off the field, knows how to deal with players.
And I know we spoke in generic terms about Michael Brdar at the toy drive, but what's the scouting report on Michael Brdar and how he's going to connect with your older players?
Yeah, well, you know what? He talks a language that I don't talk, and he talks the language that younger hitters are coming up and talking now. I should say that I talk it a little bit, but not as well as he does. And, you know, I knew coming in that on the hitting end, you need to be able to reach these guys and speak their language. And I knew 20 minutes into his interview that I had a pretty good sense I was going to hire him. He blew me away. And if you'd have told me 3 or 4 years ago I'd have a 27-year-old hitting coach, I probably would have said no. But he is that good, that knowledgeable, and understands, you know, not only the technology point and part and how to prepare, but also sounds like he's, you know, when you talk to him, he's so well studied and well knowledgeable of what he's trying to do. When you talk to a player about him, he's any player in our team that he already had ideas about what he wanted to do, yet understands he has to get to know the players before he tries to push too hard. So just a really, really smart, knowledgeable kid. It speaks the language of what these younger hitters do.
Thank you.
Hey, Bob, what did you make of how out of the box the Giants went last season with their coaching staff? Did you take anything away from that, you know, between just being the same market and now hiring their hitting coordinator?
Yeah, they had success. And I think a lot of teams look to, if teams do things a little bit differently and they have success, then you have to kind of look into that. And this is one of the reasons that we interviewed him, was to try to, you know, see what was going on over there and, you know, how they match up, how they're prepared for pitchers, how they're prepared for a starter, how the guys coming off the bench are prepared for a reliever. And he had all the answers for that. So you can understand, you look at the numbers the Giants put up, especially coming off the bench, you know, different lineups on different days for certain pitchers. He was well versed in that. And like I said, I knew pretty early on in the, you know, in the interview that I wanted to hire him. And a lot of it had to do with what was going on over there. And you're always looking to take a little something from teams that had success.
And what is Ryan Flaherty going to be doing exactly? And how closely will he be working with Michael?
Yeah, very closely. And, you know, when AJ talked about, we feel like we're doubling up in every area. Not only we help out on the hitting end, he'll help out on the infield end with Matt Williams. So we feel like we have two guys for every spot. You know, it's great to be able to bring guys back to that have some continuity and knowledge of the players. Ryan has that and is well-versed in hitting and the infield portion of it. So he'll kind of split up his duties, but That was an easy call early on when I actually met him when I was interviewing for the position. And you can see why he's so well-liked, not only amongst the players, but also about the front office.
And I just wanted to follow up with Bob on the language that you said Brdar speaks. Like, how would you describe what that is, and why is it so important this day and age to kind of have that capacity?
Well, Guys, even it starts in batting practice in the cage now with a lot of the technology that you have. You know, guy hits a ball and he says, you know, I hit that one at 18 degrees at 102. I mean, you know, you're speaking exit velocities, launch angles, and that's what these guys are well-versed in. I've learned it, so to speak, but have kind of had to move back towards that, a little bit more old school in my thoughts on hitting. And I think there's a nice balance for that too, with a guy like Matt Williams. You know, just because we're a coach in a certain area doesn't mean that we can't help everybody out. And Matt, you look at his numbers, brings a little credibility on the offensive side too. So we feel like we're really well balanced there. And, you know, and nowadays when, you know, you talk to a hitting coach about, you know, break this guy down for me. Okay, well, hits too many balls on the ground, doesn't hit spin very well, and then has answers to how we can improve upon that. I mean, you didn't hear as much of that, you know, maybe 5, 6, 7 years ago as you're hearing now, and a lot of teams are having success with it.
I just wanted to follow up on your thoughts on your seventh hitting coach and what impressed you and how you think he will help your offense.
Yeah, I think with Michael, again, I think, you know, Michael Flash, Nathan Landau, we have a group of guys that, you know, Matt Williams, we have a group of guys that, you know, feel good that they've got a lot of bases covered from a hitting standpoint. Michael, again, I think, you know, the last couple of years in San Francisco, you know, overseeing their minor league program and being the coordinator there, he's got, you know, I think he's got some, you know, from a drill standpoint, you know, how you go out and improve performance, working in a cage with hitters, working on the field with guys, you know, teaming up with Flash from an approach standpoint. I think we've got a lot of the bases checked. And again, we've swung the bat well here over the last couple of years. So it's, you know, I think ultimately from our offense standpoint, you know, we feel like we have some talented hitters and, you know, ultimately we feel like we've got, you know, with Michael and Ryan and others, we feel like, you know, we've got a group of coaches that should be able to connect with these guys and get them to go out and perform.
Yeah. This one's for Bob. I wanted to ask you about, working with, Ruben Niebla. What was, your understanding of his reputation in the game and how have you found working with him so far?
Yeah, he's been great. I mean, it's really like having a pitching manager. He understands how to get these guys ready. He comes from an organization that's always been pitching rich and pitching savvy. I know Terry Francona really well, and he speaks very highly of him. Again, during interview process, Ruben was there. I got to speak to him. This was an easy one. His reputation also, you know, came before, and I knew about him and talking to him. I knew this was the right man for the job, and speaking to, you know, the front office and the guys that, you know, had already spoken to him, this was an easy hire. So very well thought of around the game. And like I said, I have a close relationship with Tito and you know, it was good enough for me.
You mentioned earlier, the new hitting coach speaking somewhat of a different language than you.
The language that you speak.
Yeah, a lot, like a lot of people speak. You've been in the game for a long time. How much has the process of hiring a coaching staff changed since you were a young manager, given that, you know, you probably want to look at a more diverse group now, right?
Correct. And, you know, it just depends on where you came. You know, I came from Oakland where we did everything pretty much in-house. We felt like if there was somebody left, we would look in-house to begin with. And that was just kind of how the organization flowed. So this was a little bit of a different process, knowing we're probably going to bring some guys in from the outside, and we wanted it to be diverse in age. We wanted to be diverse in thinking. We wanted it to be, you know, guys that the other dynamic here is that everybody on the staff, even though some of the guys are new, they have somebody that they know and feel comfortable around. I think that brings out the best in you. When you have someone there, you don't feel like you're the lone ranger and you have to kind of morph in or you know, kind of tiptoe into a process. But, you know, the hitting end is and the pitching end are probably way more technical than when I first, you know, got into this. It was, you know, now you want to hear about these guys and how they can improve and how they're going to use all the tools and technology that are available now. And both Ruben and Michael are guys that are really well versed in that. So a little different than before in that, you know, you're talking about different areas and, you know, maybe a little bit more math involved now too with guys and coaches. So it's a lot different than when I first started, if that answers your question.
No, it does. It's not the good old boys network anymore.
Correct.
Managers hold. Hire their old friends.
I was staying away from saying that, but yeah, you probably true.